Hello. Please join us in honoring our country as the Woodstock North High School Band plays our national anthem.
Samantha Parrish, salutatorian of the graduating class of 2020. Welcome to the graduation ceremonies of Woodstock North High School. Even through these unprecedented times, I'm glad to be able to celebrate our long-awaited graduation with each and every one of you. It is now my pleasure to introduce you to the class of 2020.
Hola, yo soy Samantha Parrish, salutatorian de la clase de graduados de 2020. Bienvenidos a las ceremonias de graduación de Woodstock North High School. Incluso a través de esos tiempos inesperados, estoy contenta para celebrar nuestra graduación tan esperada con todos. Es un placer para presentarte al clase de 2020.
It is now my pleasure to officially welcome you all to the ceremony tonight. A special welcome to our board president, Mr. Carl Gilmore, vice president, Mr. Jacob Homuth, Secretary Mr. John Parisi, and board members Dr. Michelle Bidwell, Dr. Bruce Ferris, Mr. Jerry Maselli, and Mr. John Headley, Superintendent Dr. Michael Moan, Associate Superintendent Mr. Brian McAdow, and Assistant Superintendent Dr. Justin Smith. And finally, on behalf of the class of 2020, a welcome to all our parents, families, and friends and loved ones. Thank you for all that you have done for us over the years. We couldn't have done it without you. At this time, we will now hear a musical selection performed by the Woodstock North Choir.
Follow me, your bridge of troubled water. When you're down, when you're
Darkness comes.
Hello, I am Darlia Livengood, principal of Woodstock North High School. Thank you for watching our graduation ceremony for the class of 2020. At this time, I would like to introduce our next speaker, Mr. Austin Zeman. Austin will be delivering our Thunderway speech this year. The Thunderway is very important to us as a school as it defines our values and beliefs. Our Thunderway speaker is chosen through an audition process in the school, so it is indeed an honor for this student to have been chosen to speak. Please welcome Austin Zeman.
Thank you for joining us today. As a student, athlete, leader, and friend at Woodstock North High School, I'm proud to have lived by the pillars of the Thunder Way, embracing the North core values. Never give up. In everything I do, I strive to excel and achieve my goals. I discovered the power of dedication and perseverance at a young age. Since first grade, I've been committed to my education, sports, and community service. Many inspiring role models like Michael Jordan and Albert Einstein failed at first, but never gave up to achieve success. No matter what you do, big or small, never give up achieving your goals and chasing your dreams. Owning your choices. Owning your choices is easy when you make good choices. However, we do not always make the right decisions. While at Woodstock North, I learned that I'm free to make choices, but not free from their consequences. I believe there's more pride in being accountable for mistakes and indiscretions. Be responsible by owning all of your choices. Respect differences. Woodstock North is comprised of students and staff who have a variety of passions, talents, and skills. These differences unite to create a rich learning environment that is unique to Woodstock North. It is important to respect, embrace, and even celebrate our differences. Like the pieces of a puzzle, we all come together to create one image that is uniquely the class of 2020. Take chances. Since second grade, I played baseball, and I knew I would continue that in high school, or so I thought. However, I decided to take a leap of faith and join track. That leap propelled me into being the McHenry County Long Jump Champion and landed me at the state competition in long jump finals. As a team, we are ready to defend our 2019 track sectional champion title this year. We have been provided with so many great opportunities in extracurriculars and academics as well, preparing us to take chances in life. Have pride. When we set foot in Woodstock North High School on August 15, 2019, I thought, this is our senior year. So many highlights to look forward to and the culmination of 12 years of dedication and hard work. Little did we know when we depart on Friday, March 13th, that would be the last time we would walk these halls together. Although we are apart, we have been given the opportunity to come together for something bigger than any of us could have imagined. Who would have thought that staying home from school would have such a positive impact, staying home to save lives? Be proud and remember all of your accomplishments over the last 4 years. Thank you to the Woodstock North staff and coaches, my family and friends, for empowering me to pave my own path, develop my talents, and pursue my goals. The North core values have prepared me for life. Always remember, like North on a compass or the North Star, these values will guide you and give you direction for life's journey. Thank you.
Our next presentation comes from two very, very talented young women in the class who are the co-presidents of the senior class. Please welcome Jordan Knox and Jasmine Botcher.
Thank you, Mrs. Livengood. And thank you to the students, teachers, parents, and staff who made these 4 years everything that they were. As one of your class presidents, it's my honor today to highlight the legacy we've all made together, which can only be expressed by the emotions experienced today. First, and by far most important, I am overjoyed. As the class of 2020, we have earned the right to stand on this stage and accept a diploma 12 years in the making. Secondly, I'm filled with nostalgia. While it's only been a brisk 5 months since we last walked through those doors, I often reflect on all the amazing memories made. Whether it be homecoming, pep rallies, football games, or prom, Woodstock North has fostered community spirit that will be carried on through generations. Finally, I have so much pride in our class and hope for in the future we will develop together. We have persevered through so much. John Baylor SAT prep, AP calculus, sports trials and tribulations, musical tech weeks, and personal struggles, only to name a few. But our final lesson pushed the boundaries of all tradition, COVID-19. Although our time was cut short, I'm confident it has only given us a future with more purpose, hope, passion, and resilience. For that, I am grateful. Because with our newfound knowledge, we won't just put the pieces back together, but create a new picture, an evolved normal, to defy the pandemic, systemic inequalities, or whatever else lies in our path.
Though I've looked forward to this day since I first opened the doors 4 years ago, I never imagined it quite like this. It's beyond unfortunate that spring break was the last time our class attended Woodstock North High School as regular students. Even so, we have worked hard to accomplish all that was needed to be here today, and the class of 2020 has much to be thankful for. Our graduation is still recognized for its immense significance, and it should serve as an act of not only personal dedication, but also one of pride. I've never been fond of endings, personally, from the last day of summer to the final chapter of a good book, but endings are unpreventable. Leaves fall, a series finishes, and you say goodbye. Today is one of those days for our class. Today we officially say farewell to all that was familiar and all that we have grown accustomed to. But even though we're leaving, our high school careers at WNHS have provided us with enough experiences to last a lifetime. Though our senior gift may not last just as long, the class of 2020 is honored to leave their mark at Woodstock North High School with an aluminum bench that will sit and assist those outside the pool doors for years to come. Now let's use the diplomas we've so surely earned for the wonderful tools they are to help us open countless doors of opportunity. Thank you.
Our next speaker represents the Woodstock North Student Council and is the president of our student organization, Olivia Piliacelli.
Hello, everyone. To be blunt, I never expected, like most of you, that we'll be doing our senior year and graduation this way. I like to think that we have grown a lot since then and are finally mature enough to go out into the world. I think that the last few months have really shown us that. Our freshman year, we worked up to get to where we used to be. During middle school, we were at the top dogs, and then suddenly we were put into high school where we were at the bottom again. Sophomore year, we knew more, and we were finally able to learn how to drive, enjoy life, have friends. Junior year, we started looking towards the future. We worked on the SAT, and we were starting to look at colleges that we might want to apply to. Senior year, this year, we have gotten ready for the transition into life and are getting ready to go to college or to work or wherever our future may lie. Over the last few months, we have had to deal with something that the majority of the United States haven't had to deal with since 1918. Even though we had COVID-19 and quarantine against us, we were still able to stick with it and finish high school. I'm proud of the growth our class has shown and look forward to seeing what is accomplished in the future. Thank you.
Our final speaker, student speaker today, is the valedictorian of the class, Mr. Carter Miller.
Good evening, or whenever you're seeing this, class of 2020. Congratulations on this great accomplishment of finishing high school. It is my honor to stand before and deliver this message to you. But before I begin, I'd like to say thank you to a few people who, without them, I can never be where I am today. Firstly, my parents. I will be forever grateful for every opportunity you work so hard to provide for our family and your endless love and support. Secondly, my grandparents. You guys have supported me throughout my entire life, going all the way back to the youth sporting events, and for that, I cannot thank you enough. Lastly, the teachers and staff of Woodstock North High School. For all the hard work and effort you have put forth over the last 4 years for our school, we all thank you. Now, by no means was this how any of us were expecting it all to end, but regardless, we have made it to the end of our time together at WNHS, and it is now time for us all to begin a new chapter in our lives. Each and every one of us is capable of accomplishing great things with our lives, that it is only right we never settle for a life of complacency. We must always look to get the most out of everything we put ourselves to do. With hard work, dedication, and a desire to excel, nothing can stand in our way. So I challenge you, class of 2020, to set the bar high for yourself and never sell yourself short. With our great talents and potential as a class comes the responsibility to make the world around us a better place. When listening to Ms. Bailey's speech at the National Honor Society induction ceremony, the phrase, "leave something better than the way you found it," really stuck with me. It made me step back and realize how many individuals in our community have chosen to put others ahead of themselves, and just how much one can do for the greater good of their community. From our first responders to teachers and so many more in between, all of these great men and women look to leave our community better than the way they found it. These individuals are the epitome of selflessly serving in our community, and for that we should view them as our role models. Wherever life may take you, class of 2020, I challenge you to find some way you can make life better for other people and not just for yourself. By no means will it be easy, however, all of us are more than capable of doing so. One line to keep in mind comes from the Challenge Corps instructor at Mary Andrus, Mrs. Kloss, stay with the struggle. While the task you face might be challenging, the best thing you can do is to stay with it and push yourself. This is what Ms. Kloss instilled in my peers and I at a young age, and I have kept it with me since elementary school. It is something I would like to extend to you, as it has helped me countless times when presented a seemingly daunting task. For I know that it is in my best interest to never give up and figure out a way to accomplish the task at hand. The most successful of individuals in society have forever been the most determinant. They will never take the easy way out, because if it was easy to be successful, everyone would be. Keep this in mind, class of 2020, as you move forward in life and encounter crossroads. Don't let them break you, only let them make you stronger.
To everyone watching our broadcast today, thank you for watching this special group of students share their thoughts with you about their senior year. What an unusual school year this has been. I don't even know the best words to describe everything that has happened, especially for these kids. Every time we think we have seen it all, another massive change comes our way. Obviously, this ceremony today would never be the way that I would hope to have our students graduate. It saddens me to think that this outstanding group of kids will never have the opportunity to hear your thunderous applause congratulating them as they cross the stage and the finish line, marking the transition into their adult lives. These are great kids, and they are entering their adult lives at a time where our entire world is struggling. But today, I hope that we all stop and take some time to celebrate with this class from Woodstock North and help them know how proud we are of them and all their accomplishments. Several of our speakers today have commented on the accomplishments of the class, but I'm going to add a few more details. They are 229 students strong, although some of them could not be with us today because of a myriad of reasons. 41 of them are graduating with academic honors, 17 of them are state scholars, 30 of them have earned the seal of biliteracy, and 34 are AP scholars. The number of students that have shown a commitment to post-secondary education by taking dual credit classes with McHenry Community College is 104 students. They have truly excelled academically. This class has two students that have committed themselves to the service of the United States and have enlisted in the military, Bobby Melton and Yvette Diaz. Yvette is not here with us today, as she has already shipped out. We are so proud of both of these young ladies. We would have had three foreign exchange students with us today from Germany, Italy, and Switzerland. But because of COVID-19, our students had to return quickly to their home countries. Eight students are IHSA state qualifiers in their sport, and 16 of them showed that they can be both a great athlete and a great student by earning a spot on the KRC all-academic team. These students have participated in Woodstock North's first regional and sectional championships in both volleyball and basketball. They have changed the face of our athletic programs and have set a high bar for all of the following classes. Each year, our senior class selects a quote to symbolize their class. It is printed on a banner that will hang in our commons for years to come. It was interesting to watch the class leaders this year try to come up with a phrase that symbolized their year. Their choice was, "Behind us memories, before us dreams, around us COVID-19. So very true for this class. However, I hope that as they leave Woodstock North, they will focus on their dreams, and they will travel forward with our dreams for them, that they will help us make the world a better place. Congratulations, seniors, on all of your accomplishments. We wish you great success in the coming years. At this time, we would normally have asked all the graduates to stand and perform the age-old tradition of moving the tassel. So graduates, even though you are not here with us, please move your tassel from the right to the left. Thank you for watching our presentation, and we will see you all here today at Woodstock North to award your diploma. Thank you.